Resignation of Floyd Shivambu from EFF have caused a lot of speculation and hearsay. However, Floyd Shivambu did not resign from EFF because there's infighting or anything, or he's leaving EFF. But he resigned from the EFF because they want to continue with the mandate which they started while they were in the ANC Youth League, which was led by Malema, and the president of the ANC at the time, it was President Jacob Zuma. To understand this better, I'm going to play you a clip by former President Thabo Mbeki. Then I'm going to go into details, and then I'm gonna show you videos that's going to connect the dots, that's going to make you understand what is going on. Please watch this clip.
But I'm saying you have a youth league, which is called an ANC youth league, which has got a very different policy from the ANC on this matter. Is it ANC? It's not. It's a youth league, sure, but a youth league of somewhere else. So, that is saying. Take the youth league of the ANC, got affected by all of this. At some point you have an ANC youth league which has got its own political platform. It's separate, different from the political platform of the ANC. It can't be ANC youth league, it must be somebody else's youth league. What happened? Suddenly you've got, very popular thing. I think even my co-committee president here referred about land. Yeah. There's established ANC policy, which is in the Freedom Charter. If you come to me to say, now let's still do something about the land, I'd say, bear in mind what we've said in that Freedom Charter for many decades. The land shall be shared among those who work it. That was a very well thought out position, strategic position with regard to solving a number of issues here. The national question, the land question, how do we handle it? No, somebody pops up. No. Let's take the land and give it to our people. So I say, me, I belong to the ANC. Who, according to the ANC in South Africa, is not our people? There's nobody who's got our people. That's ANC policy. Somebody else's policy might be very different. But that's why the ANC says this: land shall be shared among those who work it. Black and white and whoever they are. But I'm saying you have a youth league which is called an ANC youth league, which has got a very different policy from the ANC on this matter. Is it ANC? It's not. It's a youth league, sure, but a youth league of somewhere else.
As you have heard from the video that I've just played, that at some point in the ANC, the Youth League came out with the different policies which were quite strange at the leadership of the ANC at that time. And then during that time, the ANC Youth League became more radical, and then they becoming to call for the land. This happened while President Zuma was the ANC president, and Julius Malema was the president of the Youth League. It's understood that during this time, Zuma was put a lot of influence and planted a lot of seed to the Youth League, which was led by Julius Malema. Floyd Shivambu was a deputy president of the Youth League at the time. And then the secretary general of that Youth League, it was Cindy Somagag. It was then when the ANC Youth League spoke more, or the rhetoric at that time was more of the radical transformation, where they were calling for the economic freedom in our lifetime. And then you're going to understand what is happening right now, because if you look back when President Jacob Zuma formed the MK party, he'd been emphasizing one thing, over and over again, repeating the same thing, that the black parties have to consolidate and become united so they can be able to challenge the status quo. They can be able to get that two-third majority so they can be able to change the constitution of this country, because they believe that the current constitution is not pro-poor. It's not pro-black, but it's more to protect the status quo. So right now what is going on is that Floyd Shivambu had to move from the AFF and go to MK just to test the waters, because Malema trust Floyd Shivambu to see that President Zuma is being sincere. Because what is happening, remember when MK party won the elections, it was highlighted that it is a tribal party. That is why it was dominant in KZN and in certain parts of the country where there are lots of Zulu speakers. So what is happening right now is to bring Floyd Shivambu so all the South Africans could understand that MK party is for all of us, is not a regional party. And then at the same time, Floyd Shivambu is going there to lay the foundation, because EFF as well as MK party, they're going to merge to one party, but not them alone, with all other progressive black parties, the far left, the radical parties that are fighting for land issue, that believe that the constitution doesn't support the black people or the poor people. Parties like PAC, Azapo, and so on. So this is what is happening, as we have seen that Mklitama also came and joined MK party. So this is a strategy. This is an ongoing strategy. So Floyd Shivambu is going there to lay the foundation and to see whether Mr. President Zuma is being sincere. And then the coming of Floyd Shivambu from Limpopo and joining the MK party, that demonstrated that this is the party for all the people of South Africa. Remember, the objection is to win the two-third majority, because they are hell-bent that they need to change the constitution. They need to be changes in this country. So Floyd Shivambu is not fighting with Malema or anyone within the AFF, but this is the foundation for more things to happen. EFF and MK party, they're going to emerge. So what is the benefits of the MK party from bringing Floyd Shivambu to MK party? There are two obvious benefits. Bringing Floyd Shivambu from EFF to MK party, it's going to demonstrate that MK party is not a tribalist party, is not a regional party. It is the party for everyone. Then the second thing, it's going to demonstrate that MK party is not a dynasty, because the critics, even Helen Zille, did say that MK party, it is a family party, it is a dynasty, it is the Zuma thing. After Zuma, surely who will take over? It will be Duduzile or Duduzane. So bringing Floyd Shivambu, it demonstrates to everyone that MK party going to have the elective conference, a free and fair elective conference, where leaders will be selected according to merit. But the bottom line is that black parties are consolidating, they are uniting to fight together to change the constitution, because they are pushing for that two-third majority. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. Your comment are welcome as always. Thank you for watching.